Hey robot makers, do you want to add Wi-Fi to your Raspberry Pi Pico projects? Then keep watching. For this project you'll need a Wemos D1 Mini and a Raspberry Pi Pico. You'll also need 4 Dupont cables to wire it all together. So the wiring is very straightforward. We take the 5 volts and the ground from the Pico and we put that into the Wemos D1 Mini, into the ground and into the 5 volts on there. We then take the receive and transmit, the RX and the TX pins from pin 0 and pin 1 on the Pico, and we put them into the receive and transmit pins, making sure that they cross over TX to RX and RX to TX. So there are two sets of files. There's some files that are going to be stored on the Wemos D1 Mini, and there are some files that are going to be stored on the Raspberry Pi Pico. Now they're both in MicroPython, which makes it a lot easier, and we're going to use serial to communicate between the two devices. So this Wemos is just going to communicate to our MQTT broker, and the Pico will just communicate with the Wemos D1 Mini. So the first thing we want to do is we want to flash MicroPython onto our Wemos D1 Mini. So I'm over here in Thonny, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to click on the bottom right here to bring up the configure interpreter. I'm then going to select the ESP8266, which is what the Wemos D1 Mini has, and then I'm going to select the serial port that I'm connected to. So I've got this all hooked up already. I'm then going to click on the install or update firmware. So I've already downloaded the ESP firmware. I've got version 16 of MicroPython there, and this is the 1 megabyte version, and the port is my serial port, which is this one here. I'm making sure I've got the erase flash before installing, and I've also got the from image keep. If I now click install, so I can see there that it's installing, it's wiped the flash, and it's now installing the MicroPython on the device. Okay, so we've now installed MicroPython on our Wemos D1 Mini. Let's close that and click OK. I'm now just going to press, there's a little reset button on there, and that gives it a reboot. We can see it's now rebooted. Okay, so the first set of files that I've got, I've called main.py, and the reason we call it main.py is because that means that it will boot up and it will run this code automatically. So the first thing we want to do is we want to bring in a secret file. So we don't want necessarily in our source code to show people what our Wi-Fi username and password is. So we have a secret.py, and in there we can set what our Wi-Fi SSID is, and we can also set what the Wi-Fi password is as well. I've also put in there the MQTT server. So if you want to know more about MQTT, click on the video link on the card that's displayed right now. Back to the main.py, and what we've got here is the code that I've written for this. So after we've imported our secrets, our Wi-Fi password, Wi-Fi SID, and MQTT server IP, we then import sleep, and we also import the MQTT simple client. So this is a library that enables us to communicate with MQTT servers, and we don't have to worry about all the complexities of how that happens behind the scenes. We then import ubin ASCII. That'll help us generate a random client ID in a couple of minutes time. And we also import machine and the UART and PIN, because we're going to be using those to connect to our serial. We're also importing MicroPython network ESP and the ESP OS debug. We're setting that to none as well. We then import GC, which is our garbage collection, and we just garbage collect anything that's in the memory. And then finally, we import UOS. We're going to use UOS to switch off the REPL, because when we plug in our Wemos D1 Mini, the REPL will start. This is the REPL down here. That will start automatically when we connect it. Now, we don't want that to be running all the time when we communicate with serial, because that uses the exact same serial port that we need to use to communicate with our Pico. So we're actually going to switch that off. So this UOS dupe term none actually disables the REPL while we run our code. We then just set some local variables. So we set the SSID to be whatever was in our secret, similar with the password. And then we set our MQTT server as well from our MQTT server IP. We then generate a random client ID, and this will enable us when we connect to our MQTT server to make sure that we've definitely got a unique ID. So this ubinascii.hexlify machine.unique ID will generate us some random characters. Next up, we set our publish and subscribe topics. So we set them to Pico, both of them. And then we've got a little function there that is our subscribe. So whenever a new message is sent to our MQTT server that's on the topic that we're interested in, this little subroutine will capture that and it will print it out. And it will also write it to our serial port. So that will pass it off to our Pico. We've then got two pieces of code which enable the Wemos D1 Mini to connect to our MQTT server. So there's a connect and subscribe, and there is also a restart reconnect, which essentially just reboots the device. So next up, there's some code here to just say Wi-Fi device is online. So the next three lines are responsible for connecting to the Wi-Fi. So you can see there station.connect, SSID and password, and the active is true. So we're making that connect. We then just have a little loop which says is connected equals false. So while it's not connected, it'll just keep going around that pass loop and not really do anything. Once it has connected, it'll fall through here and it will say that it's connected. We then just set up the serial. So we just wait a second just to make sure everything everything's working okay, and then we can ignore the RX and TX pins. They're actually irrelevant to this. We can then use my serial, which is our new serial variable, and we make that a UART. So it's on UART 0 and it's at 9600 baud. And both the Pico and this device need to be speaking the same baud rate. We then initialize it at 9600 and we print the message that says serial setup complete. We then try and connect and subscribe. If that fails, we just restart the device. If that's successful and we've actually connected, we can then just say Pico Wi-Fi online. We can send that and publish it to our MQTT server on the topic Pico. So if we've got something like Node-RED running, we can actually see that that code has worked properly. We then have a while true loop, which means it just runs this code infinitely. So it'll check for any client messages on the MQTT server. If there are any messages on the serial from the Pico, we can read in those messages. We can then build up a message from that serial by reading that into our message variable, and we can then publish that to the Pico topic. So topic pub and then message. And then we just have a little sleep just to enable it to do that. If there's any errors, it will then just reboot the machine. So it'll keep doing this infinitely. So the Wi-Fi companion piece is a very simple piece of code. This is going to be running on the Pico, and this simply says import pin and UART. And we then create a UART, which is a serial device on ID 0, so we're going to use pins 0 and pin 1. We then just print to the console hello world, but then we write out to our serial hello, and that will actually write it to the serial port. The Wemos D1 Mini will pick that up and it will publish that to the MQTT server. And then if we read in any messages coming back from the Wemos D1 Mini, we can then read that into our message variable. And this little piece of code here, UFT8, and ignore, just make sure that if there's any garbled messages, any characters that are not correct, just get ignored. But any true messages will be printed out to our console, and then we can act on them. So I'm going to copy all these files across to the Wemos D1 Mini. So I do that by right clicking and uploading that to the root of the device. So I'm going to do that with secret. I'm going to do that with our MQTT simple. Now we don't actually need to load the Wi-Fi companion because that's going to be on our Raspberry Pi Pico. So now that we've got those installed there, we can simply reboot the device. So now that we've restarted our device, it will run that code automatically and we won't see anything on the REPL because remember it's redirecting that to our serial port. So what we can do to check that this is working okay is we can pull up this Node-RED flow that I've created here. So Node-RED is something we've installed in some previous videos, and you can see a link to those in the card above. So I've got a flow here. What this flow is going to do, it's going to publish the message test to the topic Pico. And whenever I click that button to the left there, it will inject that into the MQTT topic called Pico. And what we've got here as well is another one which listens to any messages, and it just simply displays them in our debug window here. So if I now reboot that device just by clicking the reset button, hopefully we'll see a Pico message displayed just on screen here. There we go, Pico Wi-Fi online. Okay, so we're now in Visual Studio Code. I just wanted to switch around because this works much easier with the Pico for me. So we have the code that we looked at earlier. I'm simply going to run this now. So we get the hello world message. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, I'm going to reboot my Wemos D1 Mini, and we'll see just behind on the screen here the message when it's booted up and it's connected to the Wi-Fi. So it'll say Pico is online. I'm now going to run my code, and we can see there immediately the word hello has appeared on our screen. So now when I click the test inject node there, which will inject the message test into the topic Pico on our MQTT server, we can see there that that message is being received and being passed to our Raspberry Pi Pico just using their simple line of code here, which is this message uart.read and then converting it to UTF-8. So that means we've now got the communication between the Wemos D1 Mini, Wi-Fi, and our Raspberry Pi Pico. That means that we've got the whole thing working as we expected, and we can do some more complicated messages. So we could make robot commands such as move forward, move backwards, move left, move right. And we can also send values such as a range finder. So I hope you enjoy this short video, and I shall see you next time.